Well, good morning, everybody.
Morning.
Good to see y'all out today. Good to be in church this morning. We had a good time at the nursing home this morning. Praise the Lord. Hopefully we'll have some folks show up.
Yeah.
Anyway, if we get started. Thank you. me.
Thank you.
We've got a few birthdays this month. We've got Galen Dowdy on the 8th and Peyton Sullinger on the 23rd. So y'all see them. Wish them a happy birthday. Amen. Do we have any prayer requests? Amen. Unspoken. Anybody else? Amen. We will be having our annual Thanksgiving dinner on the 24th of November after the service, and the church will be providing the turkeys and ham. And there's a sign-up sheet in the back for all the sides, so anybody wants to bring sides to that, please contribute to the cause there. Amen. Praise the Lord. Anybody else this morning? Prayer requests? All right. Brother Ashley, will you lead us in prayer, sir?
Father, thank you for this day. Thanks for your love and your saving grace. I ask you to bless the congregation here, Father, and I ask you to bless those members of our congregation that were unable to be here today. These unspoken requests, you know what they are. We're believing that you're going to intervene in those situations and take care of them. Father, I also ask that you bless this offering. Help us to use it to do your will. In Christ's name we pray. Amen.
Amen.
Emmanuel,
God is with us.
Bless.
how. And I say thanks for the things that you have done for me. Things so undeserved.
Good to see you, Sam, one of y'all. You remember, looking back over your life, you know, I say it all the time, when I was little, and I'll say, we used to, you know, people talk about how things used to be, but you're referring back to a stage in your life when you were, didn't appear the way you appear right now, you know, when I was little. Which naturally we're talking about a period of time when we have recollection or memory of. But I can remember being on the kindergarten school bus. That was, I don't know what to call it now, but that was before first grade. And we have stages in our lives. You know, you have that period of time, then you're a preteen, then there's teenagers, and a young adult, you know, middle age, you get older. But in the natural, we have stages. And I want to touch a little bit about spiritually. We have stages spiritually. It would be a good time to get in tune spiritually. Amen. We can be all about this life. We can be all focused and dedicated on the natural. But the bottom line is this, church, we are passing through. This life is but a vapor. And the Bible does declare it is appointed unto man once to die. When people have health, they say, yeah, that's down the road. But if we don't watch it, we are creatures of habit, you might say. And we will do something, and we get stuck in certain ways. And if we don't watch it, we will totally neglect our spiritual life. And we will be all about our natural life. Not a good place to be when you draw your last breath. Amen. Jesus said, I'm about to go prepare a place for y'all. He told his disciples, I'm about to leave. And they kind of got bummed out. But he said, I'm going to go prepare a place for y'all. And he said, if I go prepare a place, I'm going to come back and I'm going to get y'all. Amen.
Amen.
And I've always said it like this, but heaven's a prepared place for a prepared people. And if we fail or if we neglect to prepare for eternity, that's not a good place to be. I'll tell you right now.
Amen.
I'll gladly give it all up. I mean, anything I got right now, I'm glad to give it all up.
Amen.
To have eternity secure.
Yes.
Oh, yeah. Y'all with me this morning?
Yes.
Did y'all bring the Bible with you?
Yes.
I'm going to start the book of Isaiah. But stages in man's life, stages in a woman's life, we all have this. Because we all need God. Anytime, you know, and I'm not belittling education. I didn't go to college. And there was a time in my life when, you know, if they said, boy, that Leon, he was a top graduate in this Yale University. I would let that kind of intimidate me. I don't let that bother me anymore, Leon. Because the older I get, I've been around some people who've been to college. I'm like, how'd you get through there? Y'all with me? But, you know, here's where I'm at. We all need God regardless of our education, regardless of your resources. You say, well, I don't need nobody. I got this, I got that. I'm going to tell you right now, you need God. We all need God. And this isn't something that I can fix. This isn't something you can fix. This is something that God has provided for us because he just wants to bless us. But what hinders, what stops the blessing of God from manifesting in our life is just simply that we fail to cooperate. Amen. We fail to cooperate. There are things in place, you know, in government or within communities. And if you just cooperate and go, you know, navigate through the system, you can find a blessing at the end. And it's the same way with God. If we'll just, you know, navigate through this precious word, and we'll just surrender to Him, and we'll just cooperate with Him. I promise you this, He'll bless you. He will bless you. But we all have a common, we all have a alike condition. Amen. Before God, we all have the same condition. Man without God is a sad state to be in. Very, very sad. Let me read Isaiah 59, verse 2. Isaiah 59, we're talking about that stage in a man's life when his true condition is brought to light. 59, verse 2 of Isaiah says this, but your iniquities have separated between you and